Hi guys, welcome back to more Dark Souls 3 with me, beaktastic. Okay, so this time a little bit of an error happened last time. We're mixing it up. I'm doing a little bit of post commentary because I messed up and accidentally unplugged my mic last time, and so it didn't record any of my commentary. So I'll try and deliver it as I delivered it last time, but here we go. So you'll notice we're back in Lothric and not quite where I said we were last time, where we ended up. And yeah, that's because we're going to rescue Grey Rat. We didn't rescue him last time. You'll also notice that I've mixed it up. I'm wielding a claymore, which is actually what I ended up wielding for most of my normal new game playthrough. And I thought I'd mix it up and go back to that.
You're no jailer, are you? No, you're from far away. And judging by the bell, you must be some of that unkindled ash. Remarkable. If that's true, then I have a favor to ask. Below the high wall is a musty little town, not the home of any lord, just a very old settlement of undead. An old woman, Loretta, lives there. Please, give her this ring. I'm not asking for charity. In fact, if you do this for me, I'll be sure to repay you in kind. I may be a petty thief, but I've more wits than most royalty. What do you say then, huh? Very well. I humbly place my faith in you. I am Grey Rat of the Undead Settlement, and I promise to assist you. Give this ring to old Loretta at the base of the high wall. Do your part and I'll do mine.
And with that, we get the blue tear stone ring, if we can find a woman called Loretta. And Grey Rat is also teleported back to Firelink Shrine. So that's everything pretty much I think we have to do in Lothric for the moment. And so at this point, I'm going to just home a bone, because I was lazy, back to the last bonfire we rested at so we can then get out of here. So going back to what I was saying just before we spoke to Grey Rat, I've switched it back up and I've gone back to the claymore, which is something that I wielded quite a lot in my main playthrough, and it was only right at the end I switched up to the Onikiri and Ubudachi. I really like the claymore, it has such a good sort of action on it, and yeah, and so that's upgraded to plus 10, so we'll switch back to that, giving that a little bit of a go. Now, as this loads, once it loads, I'm going to go back to the bonfire and we're going to end up actually going back to Firelink Shrine. First of all, we're going to go to the Undead Settlement because I've got one or two little things that I wanted to take care of there. And then once that was done, we were going to go back and then we're going to go to Firelink, because there's a few things there that we haven't really been back there since we were first there, since before we came to Lothric, and there's a few things that I kind of want to wrap up there. So we'll do that in this episode, and then we'll go to, and then we'll start in Undead Settlement. So that's our plan of action. So here we are in Undead Settlement, back where we left off, and we've got quite a nice little view of everywhere. We can see down there you had Fire and Keep, and up there we've got Lothric. And so wandered over here and picked up the item over here, which was another large soul of a proud paladin. So all the souls in New Game Plus are clearly a lot better than they were in the normal New Game, because obviously we need more souls for things. Okay, so we're gonna come back down here and I wandered over towards the gate so that we could clear this out, because there's one or two things where if you've played the game I wanted to pick up before, or find before we head back to Firelink Shrine, so that everything's there as much as possible. So I let the dogs kind of take out the little hollows wandering around, so just reduce the number of enemies in the area, even though the dogs are really the the biggest enemies. And Yeah, that's why I love the claymore. That swing, that like really powerful wide swing, which just proper wrecks enemies. And then has a good sort of thrust as part of the combo, which just, yeah. I mean, look at that. That one just sent him flying all together. A little bit of pyromancy. I like to mess around with pyromancy, but my character is not really designed for pyromancy or sorceries or anything like that. That wasn't the main aim of it, because, as I sort of said, this was my first proper Dark Souls game. I'd played Bloodborne a bit. Didn't really mess around with the arcade stuff there. And, so yeah, I kind of want to have a little bit of a play when I started Dark Souls 3, but I didn't want to have like a full mage build, because as far as I was aware, that was a little bit harder, or wasn't quite designed for it. I knew there was a lot more melee weapons, and so I kind of want to have a bit more of a play with them. And we can see here, just at the base of the high wall to Lothric, lots of pilgrims, which got to the bridge and then were stopped. And you can see there's a large wyvern just perched on the end of the wall there. They were approaching Lothric on their journey and were stopped. They got this far and they stopped. And actually, I noticed at this point that you could kind of just make out one or two items just on the other side of the bridge there where the wyvern is. Which is a nice little hint to the fact you can get over there later and there'll be some items, but obviously we can't jump that gap here, but just yet, so we won't. We'll come back for it later. So I picked those up and then we wandered over here.
Grant me death. Undo my shackles.
Because not all of the pilgrims are dead.
Oh.
So let's speak to Yol.
Oh, then it's true. A champion of Ash, as I live and breathe. To be in your presence is a great honor. I am Yol of Londor, a pilgrim, as you can see, only somehow I failed to die as was ordained. Well, perhaps my calling lies elsewhere. Say, champion of Ash, how does the idea of taking me into your service strike you? I was once a sorcerer. Surely I can be of use. Oh, I am honored, truly. I should be dead, yet you have granted me purpose anew. I, Yol of Londor, do solemnly swear myself to you.
And there we pick up Yol. At the base of the high wall, a pilgrim who did not die like the others. So we've taken him into our service, and he's going to do us a couple little favours. So I'm going to do most of his questline again, mostly because I want access to Yuria a little bit later. And now we ran over here, past all the bodies of these dead dogs, just kick him out the way, and let's open the gate. And that guy, now that he can see we're opening the gate, is just trying to leg it out of the way. But unfortunately, it's not going to quite be enough, because he's going to get wrecked, and we're then going to use the bonfire over here to then take us back to Firelink Shrine, because as I said a little bit earlier, we've got a couple bits of unfinished business we want to take care of there. So light this bonfire that's only about 200 yards away from the last bonfire, and let's take this back to Firelink Shrine. I'm getting a nice little peek at the Undead Settlement paths coming up here. So it is really cool. I like how much you can actually, if you stop and look, how much you can actually see about what's to come and items that you may miss and little paths and things that you can take. I actually really like that in this game. I think it's really clever. It's really quite nice, like, little touch. So we're now going to go back to Firelink Shrine, like I said, and a few things that we missed there previously that I either completely forgot to look at or things that potentially may have changed. So first of all, let's come over here and we'll talk to Hawkwood again. DNA.
Good. The Firekeeper must be twitching with delight. But what do you really know about these Lords of Cinder? These supposed legends? Let's take Aldrich for one. A right and proper cleric. Only he developed a habit of devouring men. He ate so many that he bloated like a drowned pig, then softened into sludge. So they stuck him in the Cathedral of the Deep. And they made him a Lord of Cinder, not for virtue, but for might. Such as a lord, I suppose. But here I ask, do we have a sodding chance?
It's a very British sodding chance. It's such a really British statement to say.
An old path still runs below the tower in the Undead Settlement. It was used to transport sacrifices to the Cathedral of the Deep. You should see where it leads. If you've the stones for it.
And that's another little hint about where we might want to go a little bit later once we're through an Undead Settlement, so our next course of action. But first, let's come up to here and speak to Leonard.
And fast on the trail of the Lords absconded. Then these red eyes are for you. Use them to pillage embers and briefly heighten your strength for your duty. What else are unkindled ashes good for? Pillage embers.
Statement that a lot of people say. What else are unkindled ash good for? Something that comes up a lot. So now we'll come around here and let's speak to Ludlith, see if he's got anything new.
My feet are here firmly planted, for I am a lord, and this is my throne. Listen, this might pique thine interest. Before I was a lord of Cinder, I was a student of transposition, the process of extracting and coalescing the essence of a soul. A forbidden art that once left a foul stain upon Corlan's honor. 'Tis an art that grants powers once thought unattainable. Most transposing kilns were lost with Corland, but this place is a crossing for all manner of cursed objects. If thou happenst upon a transposing kiln, bring it to me, quick. Now.
Don't worry, Lilith. We're going to be doing some transposing, because I got a lot of spells I need to transpose, so don't you worry. We'll be doing that. Speaking of, we've got the soul of Boreal Valley Vought, Fort Zotus an outrider knight, never far from the Fleeting Dancer. Oh, how true that is for anyone who has played this previously, or at least seen where the dancer is, or how early you can get to the dancer. They will know that's true, but I'm not gonna come to it yet. We're gonna come to it in the proper time. And let's see. I don't think there's anything particularly I wanted to buy from her. There's nothing else there really that I need. Yeah, the Firelink set, like I confirmed in a previous episode, we already got that. That's the Soul Cinder set, but I already have it, so I'm not buying it again. Andre's there. I don't really have any business with Andre, so that we came down here and we spoke to Grey Rat.
Whatever. Just don't up. Goodbye. Oh, this.
Oh, this pilgrim. And I never would I. Then shall we?
Yeah, I couldn't really bother to speak to Yol. He's far too slow. Let's get to the business at hand. So, I wanted to do his quest lines. So I need to let him draw out my true strength. And so, I couldn't quite decide what I wanted to put the points into, and there's nothing desperately I needed because I'm at level 120. I don't mind going up a little bit because it's not going to make a massive difference, I don't feel. So then in the end I decided, so that I could play with some spells a little bit more, I decided to put the points either into intelligence or faith so that I could play around with them a little bit more, and in the end I think as we'll see in a minute, I think I ended up putting it into faith just because that one was marginally lower. Nearly went for vigour because, you know, Health is always good, but in the end decided that the points would be better spent in faith or intelligence, and yeah, as we can see here, I think I end up going with faith in the end. After a lot of playing. There we go. Because it's free anyway, so free level into something I wouldn't normally level into is a feels a good bargain. But yeah, he hasn't done anything else for us, so now there's a few other bits and pieces we want to do. So for example, I picked up a very nice little tower key in the first episode, I think it was. I picked up a tower key, and we haven't even been up the tower again yet, so let's go and have a look at that. So come out here, and because I got invaded, I checked to see if there was a seed, and there wasn't, so far enough. And there's an item up here of an intrepid hero, nice another soul item, and then there's a tree with the roof, and I always like to have a couple goes at this because you can make the jump and you can still make it, because I played around and gave it a go about a week or two ago on like a new game character, just a normal new game character I started and then haven't really touched since. And you can do it, so I thought, oh, I'll give it a couple goes, but I have the tower key, so it's not the end of the world if I didn't make it. So I gave it a couple goes and yeah, messed it up entirely, so decided to give up. If I'd taken off my armour and made myself a little bit lighter, I probably could have done it. But yeah, we got the tower key, so we'll just go up the tower the normal way. So up we went, and further up we go. And out here, we'll look over and we can see Lothric Castle towering up above us, as it towers over us everywhere. And you can just about, I angled the camera, you can just about see the bonfire there that we started at. So the Cemetery of Ash must be sitting right underneath the walls of Lothric, right at the base of the walls of Lothric. Which is quite kind of interesting, I feel. Quite an interesting little lore point, but yeah. So I then remembered that there's a little crystal lizard at the bottom there, and so I was then wondering if I could get that. And decided to try and snipe it a little bit with my bow. Well, we'll see if I could snipe it with my bow, but I think when I pull it out, accidentally throw a fireball, which is not what I meant to do. But when I pull my bow out, I can't. It's very difficult to get the angle from here, and I don't massively use the bow, I only ever use it for kind of playing around or trying to pull enemies a little bit. So you can see, I can just see the lizard if I peek it over, and if I step back carefully, I can just about reach it, but then decided that if I tried, that I would probably just end up scaring the lizard off, so we didn't go for it, we left it for now. And decided not to go down to the roof either, so we're going to go all the way up to the proper tower. First, go up to the top of the bell tower, and peeking over the side there, you can see there is an item to pick up again, and there's one, but that one's at the very bottom, but there is an item on one of the grey stones. So we go up the tower. There is an event in the tower, an event even in the tower, and there's a character you can meet, but at the moment he isn't there for us to meet. So he must trigger later. I'm not 100% sure when the trigger point is, because usually obviously when you come up here for the first time, when you get finding and get the tower key, that's not usually for quite a while yet, because usually obviously when you're a normal new game, you can't afford the tower key for quite a while, because it is 20,000 souls. But because I came from New Game Plus and I have, you know, lots of souls, I could afford to get it straight away, so I did. I just didn't bother coming up. But obviously the event here doesn't trigger for a little bit while yet. But then we can see under this big bell at the top here, we've got a Firekeeper soul. And peering over the edge, you get a better view of the Eudex Gundia boss arena. So let's have a quick look at the Firekeeper soul. Soul of a Firekeeper who is said to have returned from the Abyss. The Firekeeper preserves the bonfire and serves its champion. She is said to have soothed and accepted the dark sigil which has tainted her soul, and yet her soul will one day embed itself in the bosom of another Firekeeper. Which I feel is quite interesting. It's obviously a callback to the Firekeeper souls you can get in Dark Souls 1, I believe, which is what, I believe in Dark Souls 1 it reinforced your Estus flask, but this time, tainted by the Abyss as well, it says, when she takes the Dark Sigil into herself, so obviously that's where she can heal the Dark Sigils we'll get later. But I do feel like it's interesting that it says it's tainted by the Abyss. Like I say, I'm quite into lore. And then using the bow here, I was just spotting a couple items that I had missed.
one needs.
Prithee, be careful.
What?
Prithee, be careful.